Thank all of you for coming to this gathering, the gathering of MSS. In this gathering, we have chosen to discuss on the topic masturbation, a disastrous problem faced by the youth. The reason why we choose this topic is because of the need of you to know the Islamic law and the health effects on this act. This is a very serious topic which time will not permit us to discuss it in details, but we shall discuss it in summary inshallah tabaraka wa ta'ala. As the topic indicates, masturbation simply means stimulation of sexual desire by oneself. Islamic scholars have different views on this act, but the majority of them are on the view of that it is haram, and they quote the verse in Surah Mu'minun which says, this verse is like Imam Shafi'i mentioned, he said that these verses clearly show that whosoever will look for any means of arising at his sexual desire to fulfill it, then it is unlawful. And also Imam Malik, this is his fatwa. Also Imam Abu Hanifa, this is his fatwa. Also Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, although Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, there is two riwayat on his thought on this topic, masturbation. There is a riwayah which one of the scholars mentioned that Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal said it is not haram, but it is makruh. It is makruh. However, as I mentioned, in this topic, we will consider the first school of thought and we will build our thought on it. So in short, all of them say it is haram, except for the views of other scholars like Ibn Hazm. He mentioned in his Al-Muhalla, he said that this act is not haram, and he sees the verse of this Surah Mu'minun that we mentioned, that the verse did not mention masturbation. So he didn't see that masturbation is among what Allah has prohibited, and he also quotes some of his reasons. Although scholars have already talked about it, when we look at the side effect of this masturbation, we will get it very clearly that it is very, very dangerous to our health. As we know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the glorious Quran that وَلَا تُلْقُوا بِأَيْدِيكُمْ إِلَى التَّهْلُكَ, that you should not put yourself in something that will harm you. And based on experience, I am a traditional medical practitioner. Based on experience, most of the patients that used to come with especially problem of erectile dysfunction, during the diagnosis you will find out that most of them are in excess of masturbation. So here is a research done by Maulana Abdullah Ismail. He make mention of all this. He mentioned about 20 physical harms on masturbation, and I will read them out for you so that everybody will hear it very clear. Maulana is saying physical harms. Undoubtedly, masturbation causes physical harms. Nevertheless, medical science has proven that masturbation is a cause of number of diseases. Among them are, it weakens the sexual organs and creates partial loosenings in it. So that is why you will find out your penis will be very, like, won't be strong because of the act of the masturbation you have been doing. Secondly, it weakens the nerves generally, a result of the exertion caused by this action. When your nerves are weak, especially the one of your hands, the one of the penis, the one of the brain, you will find out that even with your studies activities, you can never be focused. You may see that before you can read something three times and you will be okay with it. It will catch on your brain, but later on you'll find out now you are reading it up to 20 times. Why is it? So when masturbation have effect on your nerves, it can cause this. Effect harm number three, it affects the growth of the limbs, especially the outer part of the urethra, which is dug through which urine is discharged from the bladder and the testicles. Hence, it does not reach the limits of its normal growth. Harm number four, it creates seminal spermatic inflammation in the testicles, which causes quick ejaculation of sperm. You will find out after you get married, you can't pass more than 2 minutes having sexual intercourse with your wife. So, you see, these are just some of the effects, and we have experienced this effect practically. Most of the people we consult, they tell us this. Point number five, harm number five. It causes pain in the vertebral column, the spinal column from which semen is ejaculated. The pain creates crookedness and twisting in the back. It is something to be surprised that a small guy who is have not gotten married will come and be telling you, I have back pain. What brings the back pain? What brings the back pain? So this masturbation will kill you before your time. Harm number six, it causes some limbs like the legs to shake and shiver. What this point is trying to say is that directly, like you will start to be facing some signs and symptoms of paralysis. There was a patient who came to me. He was confused that his hand is shaking, and I told him this is a sign of brain disorders. And I now asked him, after which I discovered that it is masturbation which has caused this effect. So at this your young age, you call paralysis to come near you by yourself by doing masturbation. So it is better to avoid it. Harm number seven, it creates weakness in the cerebral gland of the brain, which in turn weakens the power of perception and reasoning. Similarly, it leads to the weakness of memory. Harm number eight, it weakens the eyesight and reduces its normal limit of vision. This one is also very viral. Many of the people who do masturbation mostly experience this eyesight and memory loss. Although according to research, in 100% of men, 75% or 90% do masturbation. So how can we avoid it? Point number nine, it causes a person to become old before time. It causes a person to become old before time. You will find out a person of 27, 28, 29 years having this white hair in his hair. Among the reason is this masturbation. We didn't say that it won't just happen because of nature. Yes, it do happen, but mostly it's because of masturbation. Point number 10, it weakens the very delicate and fine nerve and veins of the sexual organs, resulting in sexual impotency. It results in sexual impotency. So after which you have gotten married, you will be continue to be struggling on you want to get married. And we have made more research and assumption and observation on this point, on this harm of masturbation, which results in impotence. This is a book written by Al-Hussein bin Abdullah Abu Ali Al-Ma'ruf bi Ibn Sina. He make mention, though in the context he was not talking about masturbation, but he talks about some of the method which which let me find out the place. He was discussing on some of the method in which sex is done, which in most time the people that are doing masturbation also do it in that way, because at most time when you sleep and the sexual arousal came, then you now use your hand to win it. So he make mention, even not in masturbation, even with your wife, for a man to lie down like that on the bed to be the virage and then to want to come, it can cause impotence. I can't find the exact place, I will have read it out for you. Now, this is what he is saying. Walil jima'i ashkalu radi'a mithlu an ta'lu al mar'a ar rajul fa dhalika shaklu radi'u lil jima'. That sexual intercourse has a pattern which is very bad. He now gave an example that, for example, a woman should come on top of a man. He said that this is one of the radi, one of the worst, or mumuna of the. So this is, I don't know the exact word. So this is what Ibn Sina is saying. And you will find out that in most time when you will do istimna, this is the exact position people used to do it. So not even for you to do it in istimna, even with your wife, it will cause harm for you. So it is very, very dangerous. Harm number 11, it causes an excessive loss of sperm by way of nocturnal emission. When a person is entangled by this masturbation, you will find out that you will be having most of wet dreams, which will lead him, not only these physical harms, will even cause some sharia, that is religious harms. Because when you have wet dream in the night, and your father or your mother or your brother knock on your door, go and make subhi prayer, can you make prayer with that your wet dream? You have to do what?
Janaba.
You have to do?
Wow.
Janaba what?
Wow.
Yeah, Janaba. So you will find out that the subhi prayer, you will not get it in congregation. So it harms your sharia, that is religious side. Harm number 12, it decreases the natural resistance of the body, which causes body weakness. It causes body weakness. This one is also very common. A person who do it frequently, especially if someone do it very frequently, he must find himself with body weakness. This is a compulsory, you cannot escape this. When you are doing a masturbation, you will find out your body will mostly be weak. Harm number 13, it causes harm to the four principal organs. Though to me there are three, it causes harm to the four principal organs, as Maulana mentioned here, in the body, that is the heart, the brain, the liver, and the stomach. When it affects your heart, you will find out that you will be having much of waswas with you. You will not have focus on everything. This is a sign of which it affects your heart. And when it affects your brain, as we mentioned earlier, you will have weakness of memory to remember something, and even when you are talking, you will be combining some things that you're supposed to talk and some things that you're not supposed to talk on it at that time. So masturbation causes this. This is a sign of which it affects your brain. But when it affects your liver, you will find out that you will not be going to toilet every day. A normal person is supposed to go to toilet every day, every time in the morning, around 7 to 9. When you are not going to toilet every day, especially at this time, it's a sign of that masturbation you have been doing have started to affect your liver. and stomach, which will lead to indigestion at most times, especially when you do it immediately after you eat food. Harm number 14, it decreases the natural animal heat in the body, heat which straightens the soul and body. That is hararatul ghariziyah. This masturbation decreases this natural heat, which will directly also lead to body weakness and the weakness of the vital organs. Harm number 15, it causes an excessive loss of blood. Did you know? It causes an excessive loss of blood, masturbation. Remember, it takes 80 drops of blood to produce one drop of sperm. It takes 80 drops of blood to produce one drop of sperm. So when you do masturbation and you just release the sperm, you waste it. And for your blood to get another sperm, it will take 80 drops of blood to create one drop of sperm. These are just some of the physical harms. Maulana mentioned several harms, which time will not permit us to mention them. We'll go straight to how someone can stop this masturbation. That is the treatment of masturbation. We have not even started to discuss, and I'm seeing that we are having 5 minutes remaining. We haven't said anything. We'll summarize it, inshallah. In short, if you want to stop this masturbation, you should always remember the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, which he said, Ya ma'ashara shabab, man istata'a minkum. Man istata'a minkum al-ba'a falyatazawwaj. That all youths, whoever among you gets the right to get married, he should get married. And if you did not get the chance to get married, what the Prophet peace be upon him suggests to us youth is for us to engage in fasting. For us to engage in fasting. And secondly, when you want to, one of the best way for you to stop this masturbation is for you not to be sleeping in your room, only you. Because if one is sleeping in his room, only himself, once the sexual desire arouses, there is nobody aside you. Although God is watching him, but at that time you will not remember that God is watching him. So, but at least if there is somebody in the room, it might not necessary for you. It is not easy for you to do the masturbation at least. So, and more of the ways which you can stop this masturbation is you should watch the food you eat at this your ages. At this our ages, there are some food which we must watch them, because when you yourself, you know them. When you eat them, you will feel some sexual arousal.
Like
you don't know the one which
you are.
For example, many of people, when they drink milk, they will have wet dreams. They will be.
You should stop drinking.
I'm telling you the way to cut off. If you want to decrease your sexual desire so that it will not lead you to have masturbation, it will be better for you to cut it. Although it is not easy, since your mouth has been taking it for long, but at least you should decrease it. Among the food also is meat, especially the meat of chicken. Yeah, especially the meat of chicken. At this your age, you should avoid them excess. And moreover, among the food is eggs. Yes, at this your ages, you should avoid eggs, much of eggs. In short, let me summarize it. Most of the food which are protein foods, causes hypersexuality. Not just sex, it causes hypersexuality. So another way which one can stop this masturbation is for him to not to be using his phone, that is to watch pornography, to watch what we call today as blue film. Yes, because once you watch them, even if there is someone in your room, he will get to toilet and say he will do it. And this is more adverse effect. We have mentioned 16 harmful effects of masturbation, but when you are doing it in the toilet, is another, the case is another different. The case is even different. It may lead for you, if you are a male, to you yourself, you are inviting Jinn al-Ashik for you to come and marry you. Jinn al-Ashika for her to come and marry you. And if you are a lady, you are inviting Jinn al-Ashik to come and marry you. Then you will find out later, yeah, it's not easy for you. It won't be easy for you to get a husband to marry. Not even only doing it in the toilet can cause this. Jinn al-Ashik, the first reason why it's come to people, the first reason why it comes to people is by them opening their private parts. So you enter to their house. Everybody know that toilet is their house. You enter their house, you open, you didn't do zikr. Because you won't do it. At that time your mind is not there, you are not with Allah. It is only when you are Allah you will do this zikr. You will not do it. You go directly to the toilet and you go and do your masturbation there. So you enter to their house. There is no way you will do that. That Jinn al-Ashik will not visit you. There is no way. They must visit you. So as I'm saying, one of the first reasons why Jinn al-Ashik visit people is by them opening their private parts. Either a girl will stand on the mirror, you will not know what she is doing. She will take 30 minutes doing what they call makeup. She will go up, she will go front, she will go back. Who are you showing in the mirror something? So Jinn al-Ashik will come and pass, which will lead for him to conquire you. It will not be easy for you to stop. So also masturbation does. Another way for you to stop this masturbation is taqwa Allah. Taqwa Allah, fi sirri wal jahri. Fi sirri wal jahri. That you should fear God in whatever you do, whether someone is seeing you or not. Time will not permit us. We have come with very wide talks on this masturbation, but I would like to end here. If everybody has question only on masturbation. Only on masturbation. You can ask. And let me close the one question that I don't want to answer. I have mentioned in my talks that some scholars have permit masturbation. Some scholars have permit masturbation, but even them, they did not permit it in open door. They said that in a situation whereby sexual arousal come, and for example, in the environment you have, there are ladies which you might not even pay one naira, she herself will come to bring herself to you so that you will have sex with her. So, for example, at such time, it may be the only way for you to not to do that zina. So it is only in such time. But for you, you went and watched your pornography and you say no, it is that one is another different case. Or you went and drink your milk. You know that when you drink milk, your sexual arousal will stand, and you went and drink. You are on your own. It is haram for you at that time. So this is what I would like to cut that answer with it. But everybody who has any question on masturbation will ask us. The time has already... Any question?
Yes, question and answer.
Are you about Janaba?
How do we perform Janaba? Yes, this is just a part of the topic, but it's not among the topic. And as I said earlier, I will not answer any question which is not in the topic.
Among the topic.
Please, you don't have to go back to it, please.
Don't worry, we have time to it now.
Please, any other question?
Bro, what you said that if someone wants to masturbate, like for example, if you are in the gym and you decide to go to the toilet, you forget to do your askar, right? So, for the person that you said, if he doesn't want to perform it now.
Right.
So, when going to the toilet, will he remember to perform that askar? Because I see it's somehow similar, because anything bad you want to do, like your mindset of doing askar you've been thinking of. So that same person, will he do all you know? That's my question.
It is not permissible for you. You yourself, you know you want to go and do masturbation.
No. From what you said, if some scholars, some scholars say,
different scholars, Ibn Hazm, Riwaya from Abdullah ibn Abbas,
what I want to say
is that
if someone, like for example, like you said, you want to masturbate in order to prevent sin, that is, if you have women and you understand what I mean. So, is it that the person is going to perform the askar or what? Because all I see that there's not any difference because it's still the same thing. Is that askar I'm still emphasizing on?
Well, answer your question. In that case, when you don't have any other option, to our own mazahib, there is no situation where you enter that masturbation will be halal for you.
Yes.
I am a Maliki, there is not any option. Also for Imam Shafi'i, there is not any option. Also for Imam Abu Hanifa, there is not any option for you to do masturbation. It is only from Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal that we get two riwayats. One from him said it is prohibited. One from him said it is makruh. Makruh. When we say something is makruh, much of doing it will lead to
haram.
So it is better for you to avoid it. I have mentioned some of the causes of this masturbation. You should avoid the one you know that will lead you to it, even the sexual arousal.
What's the name of that gene you call?
Sorry?
What's the name of that gene you call?
Ash.
So when the person is performing that, will he come? Yes, now.
As far as death zikr is concerned, once someone do it with a clear heart, entering toilet, there is no way jinn and ash will sit here. This is the Aisha in short. But as I am repeating myself, if you know what used to cause this masturbation for you, cut it down. If it is watching pornography, stop it. If it is drinking milk, stop it. If it is thinking of lady, stop it. Sorry, excuse me, please. I didn't mention one of the biggest side effects to the ladies. Yes. One of the biggest side effects of masturbation to ladies is they will find out some pustules in their vagina. How to pronounce it? What are you doing so much? How can I?
Rashes.
And moreover, we can use the common term rashes. And secondly, you will be having itching. You will find that every time. She is doing it in the night. Is there any question?
Thank you.
Anybody who wants to read more on this masturbation, he can come and meet me. I will give him a document to read. Yes, I will give him a document. This is only one done by our Maulana Abdullah Ismail. So it is very, it will be very good for every youth to get this. Yes, it will be very good. Whoever wants it should come and get it from me.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.